Привет, друзья! Bear here again. I'm on my way to the pickup point to get another parcel. Another parcel means another review. You know where it is. Sukhoi 33, okay? That fourth gen Russian fighter. Not my typical sort of genre as well. I like sort of Skyhawks, Phantoms, that sort of era. So why that kit? Also, broke a rule here. For myself, I never buy kits from new manufacturers, because they tend to be sort of learning how to make kits, and the first runs might not be so great. So why have I changed my mind? Why have I got this one? Well, all comes down to a website called Moulding News. I saw a build up of this kit and I was so damn impressed. So let's go and have a look at the parts, see what this kit is about. Okay, here we are, the Su-33 Flanker D from unknown manufacturer, Minibase, but we've got our suspicions on who they are. Nice box art, blah, 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 blah. This is what you get inside. Let's have a look inside here. You get this cool, oh Jesus. Okay, you get this really cool color profile of two of the aircraft. In addition, you get this cartoon as well, and then we've got this box that's absolutely packed full of stuff, and my concern here is how do I get it all back in, because the box is big, it is totally full of stuff. Yeah, so clear parts, which strangely you've got two sets of canopies, but we'll have a look at all the bits and pieces. Let's see what's inside here. Sprues. More sprues with a backing. This has got like a cardboard backing on it for some reason. More sprues. There she is. This is what it looks like. That is impressive, even in the plastic. But let's have a look at outside the plastic. And typical sort of layout for these type of aircraft, the top and the bottom. Another sprue. It's they've got to dig these out. They're so tightly packed inside here. Then we've got some parts on the side here. And we've got two boxes. Take them out. And finally, at the bottom, we've got the instructions. So, where do we start? Let's do a D-bag. I'll have a look as well. I need to look through before I talk to you about it, before I tell you my thoughts, and then we'll go through the bits and pieces. And what else have I got? I've also got this. This is the extras that came from Armor Hobbies. Bit of a mystery. What's inside there? Show you later on. Show you at the end of the review. Okay, I've just briefly had a look at the instructions. This is a kit like no other in terms of aircraft I've ever seen. Considering it's a 148 scale jet, there's 56 page instruction booklet. I'm just showing you the back because you've got your typical sprue layout. And I'm going to tell you now, this has got a way, way more parts than you would ever think for a 148 scale aircraft. And what put me onto this is that I could have got loads of extra resin bits and pieces. But this model, and you're going to see in a minute, they've actually super detailed within the kit. And like, I mean, basically, this is the very first step. This is just the ejection seat. I could have bought a resin ejection seat, but when I saw these instruction steps, I thought, no way, I want to try and do this. So you're building up the seat, and there's, I mean, I'm not joking, this looks complex. To build up the seat, you've got loads of PE parts, and you know they're going to be small. And then by this stage as well, you're adding on decals onto the ejector seat. I've never seen anything like that before. The cockpit as well, it's looks like fully detailed consoles, but we'll have to have a look at the kit parts, but I'm guessing they've got relief, and it's got decal call-outs as well, or transfers. And then look at this, I mean, on some sections, you've got multiple small components getting added on. Even the joystick's got little, like, three parts. So straight away, a lot of people are going to say this is overkill. Well, if you want the detail, you know, if you want strong detail, it means more parts. This over-engineering bullshit term, they're plastic kits, they're not engineered, they don't have a function. So basically, more parts, more details. If you want less detailed kit, less parts. Just as simple as that, that's all it's about. So here's the nose landing gear, and again, PE parts, small components, the landing light, the scissors for the oleo strut, two parts. Here's the FOD guard as well on here. So you've got like, you know, a good a whole page dedicated just to the front nose landing gear, which is remarkable, really, for me. Looks like you've got some options here on the intakes. You can have them open or closed, obviously, depending if the engines are running or otherwise. You've got auxiliary intake area. Again, same sort of thing. Now, I'm looking through these instructions, and I'm thinking already, this is either Great War Hobby or AMK. It has that feel to it immediately. That's what I'm sensing as I'm looking through. But this, I mean, we could spend half an hour looking at these instructions, but if you get the idea, here's the main landing gear, and again, here's the one strut. You've got the tie-down loop there, which is, that's two parts for that part. Then you've got the scissor link, which is two parts, and another detail getting added on. I think there's a lot of people going to be like turned away from it. For some reason, yeah, I'm a bit of a weirdo. I got like turned onto it because it's got that many parts. I think the detail is going to be absolutely fantastic. Wheel bay detail is made up of numerous, so it isn't like a drop-in part. It's built up of multifaceted components. So again, detail on every single part. It just looks amazing. Looks like the arrestor hook component there. You know, this is stage 13, still detailing parts. Separate flight controls. There's some hydraulic piping here. Still adding parts. One thing I have to say though, they're clear instruction steps. And here's the flap. The flap's got PE detail. So when you've got them drooped down, you see that inner portion there. Detail again. But you add in more and more tiny, tiny little parts. Yeah, I think there's a lot of people going to be turned away from this one because of the amount of parts. But those people that are looking for something different. This is basically, to me, this is a plastic kit with all the aftermarket already inside the box in plastic MPE. That's what you're getting in this kit. So, but of course, you haven't got the options to do away with it. Well, you have got the option. Don't put on the PE parts, but I think you'd be missing out. Looks like you can extend or retract the flaps as well. That's that option's there. Detailed colour call-outs throughout how to paint and detail all this. Now, obviously, this is carrier-based aircraft. And already I can tell that I think the kit is biased towards, is it going to be a folded wing configuration, or is it going to be biased towards, you know, folded out? And I guess, I mean, for me, I need to show all that detail. I want to show all those parts. Here's a bit more. This is the glare shield. There's the HUD. And that's made out of a PE part, two plastic parts there, more PE, another plastic part, another PE part, another plastic part. That's going to go... Even the canopy frame as well is fully detailed underneath by the looks of the instructions. So this is what you're going to get. It looks like, to me, it looks like a sort of a groundbreaker. This extent of detailing, no compromises. So not a short weekend build. The engines as well, they've got like flame holders and PE details in there. Again, I had the option to get resin nozzles for this kit, and I thought, no, because I want to do that. I want to test this kit out. It looks so good. Here we are. This is like the crucial assembly step here, where basically everything goes together as one. So you sandwich the two fuselage, ventral dorsal portions together, and also all these flat parts go on. And there's the, I suppose this is an option because you can't have them. No, you can't. Right, okay, hold on, let's have a look carefully. Yeah, you can pose the wings deployed, but it should lead you towards that. It should tell you straight away which steps to follow. There should be options called out. Obviously, you're going to study this instruction booklet quite a lot, I should imagine. Here's folding wings, so that's an option. It should tell you where. Look through, obviously, look through the instructions and find out how you're going to configure the aircraft. You can even this tail portion here, that can be hooked up as well. Oof. There's the boarding ladder, and then you've got like, these are the pylons. Again, multiple details. There's the armament chart. There's the weapons. Yeah, the weapons are going to be different. You're going to see they're one part molded. Stencil call out extensive. Yeah, very extensive call out there. Wow, this. Yeah, this would keep you busy, wouldn't it? Adding all these transfers. And there's multiple, obviously, all the weapons, the pylons, the underneath. And you've got the painting guide for the cockpit as well. Well, actually, this is just the water transfer call out. So that the decal sheet is going to be interesting. There's the camo scheme with this unique naval camo. Get a few schemes inside here, but there weren't many of these. And this aircraft is basically, I think it's nearly, they used it actively in Syria, but as you know, the Russians only have one carrier and they broke it, Kuznetskov. So this aircraft, I think it's getting replaced by a MiG-29 variant. Wasn't very successful. But also as well, better point this out as well, we've got the paint call-outs, all are Mr. Color, that's all. Mr. Color only. And there's actually, to make the camouflage paints, you're directed towards using 1, 2, 3, 4 different blends of Mr. Color to, and for the second color, 3 different blends. For the third color, 3 different blends, and also 2. That is absolute pain in the neck doing stuff like that. To me, it is making up those things. Anyways, instructions done. Let's have a look at the parts. I just want to point out again that the packaging is really good, solid. Nice packaging. And here we are, straight away, two hero parts. Look like slide molding type technology employed here. And the thing is, oh wow, the detail is absolutely wonderful. Got all these little micro rivets. I'm just going to show you the detail here. It is outstanding. Micro rivets there. I don't know if that's going to show up, but it's such high quality detail, and raised portions as well. And there again, raised portions, recessed parts, panels that have actually got texture and rivets on them. I haven't seen anything like this before. Really, really sharp and fine. I'm not joking. And of course, as well, usually on some curved parts, as they round off, the detail softens out. On this one, there's nothing. I've not seen that highly detailed molding previously on any kits. Obviously, we're looking at the same part there. Here's some sprues. Just check out the wiring, the detailing that they have in there. Okay, this sprue mainly is wings. Again, this ultra fine detailing. I mean, it is. If this shows up or not under a wash, though, that is debatable. I mean, it just looks incredible. It really does. And also be aware, I mean, look at that attachment point on that part there. You have to be careful. How's the plastic as well? The plastic is, this. I love this when these people say, oh yeah, it's that type of plastic. Another. This is polystyrene, right? This, all plastic kits are polystyrene. It's the pressure, right? This is a higher pressure injected kit, because that's the only way you can get super fine detail. Like Airfix, softer detail, softer plastic. It's polystyrene, but under softer pressure. And this is high pressure, like Hasegawa, Tamiya, like hard stuff, yeah? And that's how you get this really hardcore detail. Okay, so more flight controls, and also some of the air intakes. And there's part of the interior of the canopy, and I can rub my finger across there, and those are raised rivets. And these are raised rivets inside here. Pretty unique. Then here you've got that micro detailing. These look like some of the consoles here. Unfortunately, these are raised details for the whatever console that is, obviously for the cockpit. Again, look at all this here. Wiring depicted, raised boxes. As you rub your finger, you actually pick up more detail than you can see with your eyes. It's very fine work. Real craftsmanship type model. Here we are looking at the lower fuselage surface. And again, it's got these raised rivets, recessed panels with details protruding. The main landing gear has got detail in there. Just flip that over. So the join, we'll look at that as well. This is the wing fold. It's got all the detail there. So the join's going to be these pins and running cement through there. And I don't see any warpage on anything. And again, if you've got this higher pressure moulding, flash, you usually don't get it, because the mould needs to be ultra tight. Upper fuse, just show you the underneath, to show you how these pins are basically, and this area is how you join. Fantastic layout, isn't it? Because you haven't got many seams to deal with. This is the inside of a gear bay door, and it's again just incredible detail. They must have had some amazing reference sources to get this. Looks like every single panel's been just... You're assuming it's accurate, don't you? But to be honest, I don't know. It could be totally off the mark. But with the look of it, it just looks incredible. Again, recessed areas, panels, and then also protrusions as well. So they just capture everything. There's the wing strengthening plate there as well. So you don't need to do that in photo etch. They've captured that, you know, fantastic, in plastic, thank you. Got two sprues in this bag. Start off with this one. And yeah, like I said, there were resin wheels that were offered, but I wanted these ones because they've got the sidewall detail on them. They've got everything. And the hobs as well, with that distinctive pepper pot thing for the cooling of the brakes. There's the louver for the auxiliary intake. And that looks sharp. Here are the engines, they're slide molded. I could have got resin nozzles really cheap. These are ultra thin. I mean, I can actually flex them with my finger. These are just, they look so tight, honestly. Looks like you've got an option as well. You can have them, you know, in two configurations, open or closed nozzles. Let's see if there's anything out there. First stage of the fan. That's the pitot tube, but I think there's an extra for that included within the kit. We'll find out. And this is actually, yeah, a mirror of the other sprue, so I've already seen all this. Two sprues in this bag, pylons. And the pylons are in two halves. Well, actually, not all of them. Not all of them are. Some of them are. Looks like it's got the detail for the underneath of them as well, which is usually missing on a lot of kits. Again, the same sort of thing. You got the raised portions, recessed, and again, very small, intricate detailing. This is the sprue that had that cardboard reinforcement in it. This is the boarding ladder, which is great, isn't it? That's going to be totally usable. The main landing gear are slide molded, one piece. Just awesome. I haven't seen that before either. There's the nose landing gear as well, one piece. The nose is as well, one piece, slide molded. And so is that rear, I don't know what you call it, beaver tail, whatever you call it. And I think these are the ECM pods that go on the wingtips. Here's the consoles. It looks like you've got an option here as well. I should have checked better inside the instructions. But these have got detail, obviously, moulded on. There's the tiny little cockpit tub with detail inside, including the footrests. Just looks exceptional, really. And small detail parts throughout. So you're going to be busy looking through the sprues. You're going to be very busy building this one. Two sprues, thus. These are not mirror parts. Are they mirror parts? K and J, so they are different. And here's all your tiny, tiny little detail parts that you need to carefully place on to fully detail the model. And on that sprue, there's 130 parts, 130 small detail parts. On the J sprue, 109 very small, intricate little details, including the scissor links and, you know, all sorts of little parts. Well, I tell you what, guys, don't build this on. This is going to be carpet monster delight, isn't it? So there's the tie downs there. What can I say? Sprue L is similar. More and more detailed little parts. This is part of the ejection seat. The detail on it looks amazing. Yeah, so that's going to take what? How much time is it going to take to build up that seat? That's going to be one video episode, I can tell you that much. Oh, little detail. There's the scissor links there that I've got the lightning hole in them as well. And all these little things that you break off, all the pitot tubes, etc. And more little tiny, tiny details. And there's 92 parts, like so. Transparent parts with the canopy. Ultra crystal clear. Of course, you also got that seam line there to deal with, as usual, with all these types of canopies. And all your HUD. Another part of the canopy as well. And very, very small details in clear as well to add on. Don't know why there's two canopies. They seem to be, let's see, that's 7 and 8. That's 8 and 9 for some reason. There must be some difference somewhere. Have to find out later on when we're building it. Okay, here we go. We know what's inside here. very, very Great War hobbies to me, or AMK. And these are just unbelievable. And that is, these are ultra thin as well. The fins on them are ultra thin. Incredible. Put those back inside the box. So what are those? Those are R27 ERs times four. Could have got resin weapons for this again, turned it down because you'll be getting this. So this is the R73s, R27s. Same thing again. Moulded on, super crisp. Super crisp detail. Incredible. So it's got an air-to-air loadout, looks like, basically what you get inside the box. Okay, in this bag you've got a metal pitot tube. I'm not going to take it out, I don't want to lose it. incredibly well detailed. Then you've got something. Maybe these are addendum markings, I'm not too sure. And I better open this up, I better show you this. Here's the truth of the matter. You've got, like, this is way more PE than you're used to for aircraft kits. Three frets, and some of these are ultra small parts, like tiny, like those little hooks there. The other parts are pretty manageable. It's very flexible, very thin brass as well. There's the HOD there as well, the HOD kit, the frame for the HOD. And a lot of these parts, I think, are going to be for the harness for the pilot. Like there, there's the back of the seat against that really thin PE. And they're more tiny little details. So, yeah, it's going to test your skills a lot, doing something like this. Okay, we're looking at the water transfers. Nudge, nudge, wink, wink. They are designed by Galaxy Decals, which means nothing to us, to be honest. But yeah, they look really tight. Obviously, the proof of the pudding is when you lay them on. But what I can tell is that there's no carrier film. Basically, it's right on the edge. If I sort of try and twist it in the light, you'll see that the carrier film ends on the decal on the water transfer, on the sticker itself. These are all the way around. The colours and everything look great. Hopefully they're nice, because that's what you've got there to work with. Okay, hold your breath. Here's the stencils. That is going to be, fortunately they've divided them out, yeah, so wingtip pylon, instrument. And they've got them all in nice little sections. That's going to make things just a little bit kinder. You know, intake gear here for the weapons there. That's going to help things. I like the consoles. They look pretty good. They look really good, actually. And again on this one as well, just multiple transfers. There's the, at least, yeah, it's going to help. You know, landing gear, so sort that out. Intake, nose gear bay, ejection seat, cockpit inside. That's really going to help. There's common, all the, you know, do not walk, and the, you know, hold down points and lift points. Beneath, left, right. That's really going to help, but there's a shed ton of stickers to put on anyways. I'll be honest, guys, I'm still catching my breath from looking at all those parts. I've never seen anything like it before. Or maybe I haven't bought a kit that's like that. So these are my extras that I got, and this is because I got a pre-order from Armor Models. And if I tell you how much the model cost, I think you guys ended up crying. And these are freebies, because I'm part of the, I've spent so much money at Armor Hobbies that I'm part of the VIP crew. So when I do a pre-order, I get some extras, including the bust of this Russian aviator. I've never painted a bust before, but here we go. What else did I get? I've got the paint set. Now, I've used these paints before and they are really good. They're acrylics, but now I'm already concerned about something because the detail's so fine. I'd have to use a primer, and if I've got a primer, am I going to obliterate detail? Someone will want to find out. I've got an extra, another pitot tube, you know, just in case I lose one, I suppose. And the other freebie as well is this is 3D printed, the FOD guard for the nose landing gear. Let me get, I think I'll show you this close up. I want to see, this is how things are moving now, aren't they? It's obviously, it's cast resin, but my goodness me, that is beautiful, isn't it? Yeah? I should have checked to see how they did that part in the kit, but I've got a resin part there for that. That was a freebie. And then this is the only extra that I ordered, and even now I'm thinking like, am I going to use them or not? And it's just the aerials in resin. But some of them, like the, you know, those three-pronged doodads, I think they're identification friend or foe aerials. Wow, they are tight looking. My God, they are tiny. These are like... Are they going to survive? Yes or no? That's the question. Anyways, that is the Minibase Sukhoi 33. I'm pretty much blown away. Who wants to see it getting built? Start voting, guys. Start voting if you want to see this one getting built. I've got an idea of actually how I would do the build in very small sections. But hope you enjoyed the review. Tell me your thoughts. I think a lot of people are going to be saying way, way too many parts. And even myself, I'm sort of like, I'm a bit woof, you know, but I wanted it for that reason. So anyways, this is the Bear, and I'll see you in the next one. Hope you enjoyed the review.